Christmas!
Good evening and welcome to the Rio Hondo Baptist Church on Christmas Eve 2019. We're so glad you could join us this evening. Let us stand and greet one another, shake hands, say Merry Christmas, give each other some hugs, and we will sing, Come on, Rainbow's Bell.
Oh, lift up thou the veil.
The whole world waits in anticipation tonight. Some waiting for Santa Claus. But we wait to celebrate the birth of Christ. And we anxiously await his second coming.
Amen.
As Christians, that's what this time of year is all about. The manger and the cross. So Mr. Chapa and I worked on called Little Drummer Boy. And usually on Sundays we kind of tell him to, you know, not get too loud, but he has a little bit of freedom tonight. See, we even have him caged up. No, we hope you enjoyed Little Drummer Boy. Service, and We really enjoy having them both part of our church family. At this time, we're going to ask Ron to lead us and Adrian. Well, we're all going to sing with him. It's called Jesus, What a Wonderful Child.
Song.
preparation for tonight, I borrowed an instrument that my wife hasn't played in 23 years, 20 years. And this is how we met. She came marching by during band practice. And I said, wow, she really plays beautifully. So we're going to do a carol for you this evening called Angels We Have Heard on High. Tremendous blessing to us. She has a medley for us to hear and enjoy. Kristen? Thank you. you walked in early enough. We had a group of, I guess they're all students. Some are in college. I think one's in high school. But these guys are our Bobcats from here, Rio Hondo. Can you make it? And they blessed us with some Christmas music. They're going to do two tunes for us. And I know they're going to bless your heart.
Amen.
Please stand. I would invite the children to come up and join me on the platform this evening as I share a few words. Just come up here and take a seat, guys, anywhere you want to. Parents, you don't have to worry about them too much. They won't bother me. Y'all just grab a seat anywhere right up here. Take a seat. Sit down. Get comfortable. There you go. Just give me a little room right here. We'll be all right. Looky here. Isn't this beautiful? Yeah. Parents, don't worry about them. If they walk off, that's okay. As long as you grab them out there. And if you need to, parents, you're welcome to come up here and sit with them as well. Boy, look at that group. Why don't you two girls move over here just a little bit so I don't step on you there? Let me help you. There you go. Oh, right there. There you go. All right. Always like to hear what kids have to say, right?
Yes.
And it's at this point that parents begin slipping out the back door afraid of what their kids might say. All right. Okay, well, y'all can have a seat. I'm sorry. Take a seat. Get comfortable out there as well. No falling asleep, though. Isn't this a good-looking bunch? Wow, what do we got? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 24. Praise God. Well, you know, I'm going to be talking for just a few moments this evening based around the question, what are you waiting for this Christmas? You're going to do what? Get your candle? Did you forget your candle? Okay, Ryan, get it. What I want to start out doing this evening is I want to start out asking these kiddos what they're waiting for Christmas. Nathaniel, what are you looking forward to for Christmas?
I'm looking
for my... Hang on just a second. Oh, there we go.
I'm looking for my dad.
You're looking for your dad? Dad? Wait a minute. There he is. Abigail, what are you looking for?
My mom.
You're welcome. All right. Well, I'm sure she's there somewhere, too. Axel, what are you waiting for this Christmas?
Presents.
Presents. Any kind of presents. Anything. What are you waiting for? Presents. You guys, y'all want to share? Say hi.
Hi.
All right. All right. Anybody else? Come on. You can sit right up here. You'll be fine. What are you waiting for this Christmas?
Candy canes?
Candy canes. Well, I bet we've got some of those tonight. What are you waiting for?
For family.
Family. Well, that's a good one. Nathaniel, you going to try again? Okay.
A Christmas present.
Christmas present.
Jesus' birth.
Jesus' birth. Amen.
A present.
A present.
My dad?
Presents? Your dad? All right, all right. Well, presents. Presents, Cecilia?
Spending time with
your
family and making memories.
All right, spending time with family and making memories. Hey, buddy, what are you waiting for? Presents? All right. Keep that thing away from me. What are you waiting for? Come on, Abraham. There's got to be something you're waiting for. Yes, no.
Spending time with my family.
Spending time with your family, okay. Praise God. Family. All right. Well, that's. Oh, I missed you. Yes, I'm sorry.
My mom?
You're waiting? All right. All right. Well, you know, we all consider Christmas kind of a time of waiting. We've all been children before, and we know how we anticipate the time of Christmas and the things of Christmas. You know, we begin to see the Christmas tree go up, and we get excited, and we begin to see gifts being put under that tree, and we get more excited, and you know, so many things about this season excite us. It's that anticipation of the moment, especially as children. We've got a future organist. But you know, yes, ma'am. You've got a candle. All right. But what happens is, as we grow older, we tend to begin to get bogged down in the commercialism of it all. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Those of us that are parents, and we know what that's all about. But you know, we begin to wonder, is that really how it ought to be? You know, perhaps it would do us all well to refocus our attention and to refocus our perspective. Oh, here comes some more. All right. Come on, guys. Hi, guys. How y'all doing? Good. Have a seat. Stay a while. All right. Okay. They didn't get to talk.
Oh, okay.
I've been told they didn't get to talk.
What are y'all waiting for Christmas?
Presents.
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 Same thing? Some presents? Be nice?
All right. Is that better? All right, thank you. Oh, you need to talk. Okay. What'd you say?
Presents.
Oh, okay. All right. I'll tell you, you give some people a mic and they just can't be quiet. But you know, this is the joy of it all, amen? It's really what it's all about, is to see the happiness and the joy on these little ones, and to see all that's going on in their minds and in their hearts and in their thoughts. But I wanna focus on a question tonight. I wanna focus on this one question: what are we waiting for this Christmas? And I wanna look at a passage of scripture. It comes out of Luke chapter 2, and I want to share this scripture with you. Luke 2 verse 25 says, "There was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was righteous, and he was devout. He was looking forward to Israel's consolation, and the Holy Spirit was on him." Now, it had been revealed to Simeon by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he saw the Lord's Messiah. So Simeon, guided by the Spirit, enters the temple complex on this particular day. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform for him what was customary under the law — we've got somebody collecting candles — Simeon took him up in his arms and he praised God and he said, "Now, Master, you can dismiss your slave in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation. You have prepared it in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and glory to your people Israel." This man Simeon, first one we're going to look at this evening, he's a man that's waiting. And it goes on to say, his father and his mother, that was Mary and Joseph, were amazed at what was being said about him. And then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "Indeed, this child is destined to cause the fall and the rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, and a sword will pierce your own soul, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." Then there was also a prophetess by the name of Anna, who was a daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was well along in years, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and was a widow for 84 years. She did not leave the temple complex, rather she served God night and day with fastings and prayer. Now that's dedication, folks. At that very moment, she came up and she began to thank God and to speak about him to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. Now, here in Luke's gospel, we're introduced to two particular characters who come on scene kind of at the latter part of what we would consider the Christmas story. One was Simeon, another was a woman by the name of Anna. She had been a widow for over 80 years, and she had committed her life just to being right there in the temple and fasting and praying. But I want to look first at this man Simeon. I want us to notice a few things about this man Simeon. The scripture tells us there was this man in Jerusalem. His name was Simeon, and this is where it tells us about him. It says he was righteous, he was devout, he was looking forward with great anticipation to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. Simeon was righteous before the people. He was devout in his relationship to God. But above all things, the scripture is telling us that guided by the Spirit of God, he was looking with great anticipation for the coming of the Messiah. Now, the prophets of old had shared prophecy after prophecy, promise after promise from the Word of God concerning the coming of the Messiah. The time was just right. Simeon had been, the Holy Spirit had spoken to Simeon, had shared to him, even as old as you are, you will not die before you get to lay your eyes upon the Messiah. What a glorious promise. The Word tells us that he is guided by the Spirit on this particular day. He goes into the temple courts, the Scripture tells us. The Spirit leads him in there, and when he sees the Christ child, it tells us that Simeon took him up in his arms, he praised God, and he said, "Now I've seen just what I've been waiting for." That's what he was actually saying. "God, thank you so much. I have beheld the Messiah, your Messiah, who has been sent to save our people." And he said, "Father, now you can release me. I've seen it. This is what all of my life has been about." Have you ever had that kind of anticipation of the Lord and the things of the Lord? Have you ever had that kind of desire to be so indwelt by the Spirit of God that all your heart is looking forward with great anticipation to the promise of the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ? What a glorious moment that's going to be. He came the first time as a baby in a manger. He's coming the second time as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, riding in victory. Glory to his name. Amen. Second, we're introduced to this woman named Anna. Says there was a prophetess. Her name was Anna. She was a daughter of Phanuel, who was a priest. She was of the tribe of Asher. She was very well along in years. She had lived with her husband for 7 years after she had married him. He had passed away, and she had been a widow for 84 years. This woman was probably right around 100 years old. But her heart was sold out to serving God. And it says that night and day, she stayed in the temple praying and fasting, always looking forward to the fulfillment of the promises of God Almighty. And on this particular day, her hopes and her dreams were fulfilled. As verse 38 tells us, at that very moment, at just the right moment in time. Isn't it incredible the way God has led Simeon at just the right moment? At just the right moment, God has led Anna, and there they are to meet the Christ child. And what does she say? At that very moment, she came up and she began to thank God and to speak about him to all those who were around about, looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. Think about it. Mary and Joseph, they come on scene, and Anna immediately recognizes the fulfillment of God's promise. And all she can do is give glory to God for his greatness for his glorious mercy and his graciousness. Folks, let me tell you something. We need to get back to the place where we begin to praise God and we begin to worship God and we begin to honor God. We begin to recognize all the greatness that God is constantly pouring out upon us. Folks, let me tell you, we as awful as our nation has become, we are still extremely blessed in this nation to have the freedom to do just what we're doing tonight. Amen. To have the freedom to walk out into the streets and to carry a Bible and to hold it high and to speak of the Lord in public. We still have those freedoms. Glory to God, because we've got brothers and sisters around this world who are losing their life for doing so. Just for converting to Jesus, they're losing their lives. You know, we in America are some of the most ungrateful people. We have the greatest blessings, and yet we are the most ungrateful people. Folks, let me tell you something. If you don't catch anything else tonight, I want you to catch how you and I need to learn to be gracious unto God, to be thankful unto God, to be thankful to others for what God is doing. You know, we went out with the bus yesterday and we handed out a lot of toys in the community and up in the Colonia between here and San Benito. And you know, there were sadly very few of those kids actually thanked us. In fact, many looked at what they had and they wanted something else. It's a picture of our nation, folks. It's a picture of the heart of the people in our nation. Never quite happy with what you've given me. Yeah. Folks, you and I have got to begin to portray to others, to the world around us, what it means to be grateful, what it means to be thankful, what it means to reflect how gracious we are for the abundance of blessings that is being poured out upon us. Amen. Folks, listen, as I draw this down, salvation has come to all of us through Jesus Christ. That little innocent baby lying in the arms of his mother, who seemed so incapable of anything on his own, would 33 years later stretch out his arms on a cross. He would shed his precious blood for the sins of humanity. When Jesus came, he provided the very things that Simeon and Anna were waiting for. God's comfort, God's forgiveness. But how would you answer that question today? Out of your heart, how would you answer that question? What are you waiting for this Christmas day? What are you waiting for? What's in your heart today? What is it you're looking forward to? What is it you're needing more than anything else? Maybe some of you here are really hurting. Maybe some of you are feeling lonely or empty or afraid. Maybe this past year has brought real sadness or heartbreak to your life and to others in your home. You've lost loved ones, and I know we have some here. Very difficult time of the year for those who are going through these types of hardships. We praise God for the comfort of His Holy Spirit tonight. We thank God that we can reach out to Him and He will comfort us. He will encourage us. But He also calls you and I, as members of the family of God, of the body of Christ, to also reach out in love to these who are hurting, to these who are living lives of desperation. Folks, we need to learn to love one another. We need to learn to reach out to one another. We need to learn to reflect the love of Jesus Christ to those around us. You know that old song, "What the world needs now is love." And there's no greater love than the love that God has shed abroad in our hearts. Amen. And it's that love that should be reflecting to those around us. Should be reflecting through us and into the lives of others around us. Folks, let me tell you something. There's no better time than Christmas. to recognize that all you could ever want or need is found in Jesus. We've learned that all the things of this world can never bring peace and never bring happiness. It's like handing those little kids a present. They look at it and they say, "No, I don't want this. Give me something else." We can be easily caught up in that. That same type of mindset, you and I can easily be caught up in that. I want to encourage you all to be reflectors of Jesus Christ, to be reflectors of the love of Jesus Christ. I want our church and our church family to reflect Christ to our communities, to the neighborhoods that we go home to, all of us. May they all truly know that our heart belongs to God Almighty. And we are children of the King, and we are an individual that they can come to and trust in to receive prayer, to receive love, to receive someone who will care for them. Let's try to make that Christmas this year, folks. Above all things, let's make that Christmas this year. Let me pray with you. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity we've had to come together tonight. Lord, this most glorious night, as we are anticipating the Christ child, Christmas Day, celebrating the birthday of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, it's great to see these children up here. It's so wonderful to see the smiles on their faces, Lord, and to know the joy in their hearts. And Lord, I just pray for them. I pray, Lord, that you will meet their every need. I pray, God, that you will bless these kids in a special way. Lord, that you will use our church and our church family to pour love into them, Lord, that they may truly know what it means to feel the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, for our church family, I just pray a very, very special blessing upon all of them, Lord, that have gathered here tonight. I pray your blessing on all, Lord, that are gathered under this roof. God bless. Thank you, Lord, that we have this opportunity tonight. Thank you for the gifts that have been given, that we're going to be able to give out to these children tonight. And Lord, we just thank you for blessing our church. Lord, help us to be a blessing to our community. I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I want to invite